guys, it's Melissa. If you are looking for a sticker printer that can print on rolls, a roll sticker printer, this little guy disguising itself as a label printer is going to be awesome for you. Look at this. So here you can see I printed this roll of stickers. It could go on and on and on. I did 10. Here I have different sizes. Again, this was done in a roll. I just did 5 sets. But the point is, this is very easy, very fast to use. It is Mac and PC compatible, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do this. This thing, as I said, it dubs itself as a label printer. I call it a magic sticker printer. So let's see. Let me show you exactly how you can print rolls of stickers, because I know a lot of sticker shops out there want to print rolls. All right, so we are going to start here in iColor Custom Cut. This is the software that runs the iColor 250 sticker printer, PC and Mac compatible, as I mentioned. So I have other videos on how to set up your work area if you want to change the page size, different things like that. I am going to use this default of 4.25, which is always going to be the size across by 4. All right, so for this roll of stickers, we are just going to print the same sticker all the way down the roll. Okay. All right, so I'm going to open up my file. So I'm just going to go to File, Import, and then I'm going to find my sticker. So I'll pick one of these. These are PNGs. They don't have any cut lines on them right now, so we're going to create that once it comes in. So first of all, it's very large. Right click, transform, scale. I'm going to change this to be a 4-inch sticker. I want to keep it proportioned, so I'm just going to go like that, and that is going to fit directly onto my work area. Now, if I want to make it any smaller, I can just scale down using that right corner window or right corner icon. Okay, so right now, do you see this green line? That's where the cut line is going to be. So I need to create the cut line by just clicking the trace tool. It's going to find the design and trace. Now, this one has a slight white edge around the border of the sticker. Don't worry about that quite yet. So we're just going to click OK. And it's going to put now a cut line right around the edge of the design. So I want it to have the border. So I'm going to go up here. We need to click the offset path, and then we're just going to tell it where, how far off do we want. So I want mine to be 0.1. Click OK, and it now is going to move the cut line out there. So do you see that? All right, so this is now my sticker. So the next part, in order to make this a roll of stickers, what I need to do is go into print. So I have my whole list of printers here. These are all the printers connected to my computer. I need to obviously pick the iColor 250. Now, this is where you are going to set up the print. So if you want a roll of stickers, let's say I want 10 of these. All right, so I'm going to change the number of copies to 10. I need to make sure that I am on print and cut, because I wanted to not only print the sticker, but also contour cut the sticker. And then I'm going to go through these other options. I typically don't change any of these, except when I get down here to printer options. So this here, where you get printer options and it opens up printer features, if you click the little icon there, this is where you are going to set up the different printer options. All right, so here under print quality, you can decide, are you going to do this as a draft? Do you want it to be the best quality? I will tell you that the further down the list you get, the better quality you get, but it will take slightly longer. This is still a very fast printer, but just so you know. Color matching, these are your print profiles, and they are based on the type of material you are using. So right now I have a sticker roll in there, a continuous sticker roll, but you could also put vinyl, you could put gold or silver sticker paper, you could put BOP, which is like a poly type material. So there's different types of material that you can put into this printer as well, depending on what you want to do. So I am going to use the gloss premium because that's what I have in there. And then if you want an even better quality, but again, going to take a little bit longer to print, you can change from bi-directional to unidirectional. Okay, so for right now, for the purposes of this video, to make it print you know, a good quality but also at a decent speed, I'm just going to keep it on bi-directional. Okay, now before you click print, you need to open up the utility. So we're going to open up the print center here, and that opens up my printer utility. You don't need to do anything in these first two, most likely. This third option here is where you're going to get a whole bunch of options. So I don't typically do anything on these first two. All right, just leave those alone for right now. Do make sure you're on continuous though. And then output. So when do you want your row of stickers or your roll of stickers to cut, to sheet cut? I do not want it to sheet cut until I'm at the very end. Okay, that's what makes it a roll. So I'm going to tell it that I want to cut after I press the button, and the button is the feed button on the front of the printer. So I'll get to that at the end. All right, next thing, you need to go into XY cutter and just make sure that your knife pressure is set to the correct material based on the material you're having. So I typically print on or cut on a 3 or a 4 for this sticker paper, right? And then there, you shouldn't need to do anything else. So just click set, and then you're all right here. And we're gonna go back to our printer settings and click print. Okay, the printing is going to start in just a second. What it's going to do is going to print each label or each sticker, cut each sticker, and then move on to the next one until you have as many copies of it as you said. Now, I'm going to tell you exactly when it's done one printing one sticker. Remember, we put it on best quality. So it's taking, it just finished printing. Now it's going to cut. Okay, so that was about 20 seconds for each label to print. Now, as they go down the roll, it's going to start coming out the front. You can see now it's moving. Okay, so the reason that I like to do it this way, as opposed to a long line of, say, 10 stickers in on my sheet, on my page, and then having it cut, is I find that the calibration for the printing and cutting, because you're not using a registration mark, is better when you cut each individual sticker as you go. Now, while this is printing, is a good time for me to tell you that if you are looking for personalized help, one-on-one support with your iColor machines, whether that's this iColor 250 sticker printer, whether it's your iColor Uninet DTF printers, Uninet sublimation printers, or the white toner printers, I offer all of that personalized support, same-day help through Silhouette U. So I will link to that in the description below. You can use the coupon code YouTube for half off your first month. I will also tell you that all of the information for where to get the best bundles on the iColor 250, all of that is in the description below as well. So there are different bundles that you can get. They come with different materials. I think one or two come with an extra set of ink, which also brings me to a good point. The ink on this is very unique. Okay, it is, I'm going to show it to you. It is CMY. It does not have black, but as you can see, it prints black. So it comes in a little cartridge like this. I don't want to open it because I don't want to break this seal, but I'll show it to you when this is done printing. But what it does is it has its own print head on there. So if you end up having trouble printing for some reason, you might just be out of ink, but when you replace the print or the print head, or not the print head, when you replace the cartridge of ink, CMY, what you're doing is also replacing the print head as well. The maintenance on this is very, very low. It's a great quality printer. You can also do lamination, which I have done on some of these other examples. And as you can see, you can not only contour cut, but you can also cut, instead of doing a roll, you could do individual sheets. And again, as I mentioned, a whole bunch of different materials for this printer as well. So this is a really great alternative if you are looking for a small footprint sticker printer. If you don't need something as big as the Roland, if you don't want something as expensive as the Roland, if you don't have a need to print transfers, heat transfers, but you are really a sticker shop, you're looking to print sticker sheets, sticker rolls, individual stickers, die cut stickers, different types of custom stickers, like I said, like gold, silver, vinyl stickers, laminated stickers, you can do all of that here on the iColor 250. Okay, so that was our full roll of 10 here. So now how do I cut this off? If I press feed, it's going to advance, and then you saw how that rolled. So here is my roll of stickers. I'm gonna show you how easily this weeds in just a second. I need to take you over to my table, but this is how you can make a roll of stickers. Again, they don't have to be this size. You could put, you know, two-inch stickers across and go all the way down the page. I've done that as well. Okay, now we'll just weed this. So if you were presenting this to a customer, you could weed this for them to make it so it's easier. You can't even see that I'm pulling off the make it easier for them to remove the stickers, okay? So here's just the weeded amount. Again, these are stickers, like paper-based stickers, but you could also print on vinyl stickers as well. Like I said, you could also laminate. If you're looking for a video on how to laminate, I have that as well. So there you go. There are your two rolls of stickers. I'm going to drop these so that you guys can see all the way down. They are upside down because of the way that I rolled them, but here you go. So if you are looking for a roll sticker printer, this is it, print and cut machine. There are very few print and cut machines on the market that are desktop size. The Roland, as you know, I absolutely love my Rolands, my BN2 and my BN20A, I absolutely love them. However, they are a bigger footprint. They are much more expensive to jump in. And while this is not an inexpensive printer, it is much more affordable when you are a beginner, when you are a small shop. If you are a sticker shop and you don't need the ability to print something that's 20 inches wide, or you don't need the ability to print on heat transfer or different types of banner materials, if you're just solely a sticker and label shop, this is a really, really great option for you, and I encourage you to check it out. Also, I will link to all of my other videos on the iColor 250 in the description below. And as I mentioned, if you're looking for help, one-on-one help on the software or anything like that, I will also put those links in the description below as well.